had no loving arms to hold me. Every day I wake up, then I start to break up.
Hey guys, Brit McBricksworth here. Today, I am going to show you a mock creation, not by myself, but by Nat Bricks. Now, you can check out Nat Bricks on Rebrickable. I'll leave a link in the description below to the mock that I'm going to show you today. But first, let me tell you about McBricksBricks.com. If you haven't been there already, what we do is we find all the good deals out there, put them into one place, one little nice presented website, and all different manner of all different Lego things. So we've got light kits on there, we've got display stands on there from different manufacturers, and we've got places where they have Lego sales on. So check out McBricksBricks.com, go on one of the links on there, and you can find the best things that you want for your Lego. Simple enough. But enough about that, back to what we're showing you today. Today I'm showing you a mock, like I said, from Nat Bricks on Rebrickable, out, which is made out of the Lego Creator Fiat 500. Now I chose the blue one because I'm quite awkward and I don't want everything that's the same as everybody else's, which is the yellow one mainly. Lego produced this blue one, didn't sell really well apparently, so but yeah, I like it. And let's show you what it looks like when it was built into something that it wasn't intended to be. So Nat Bricks has made out several mocks on Rebrickable, and this is one of them, the Ford GT. And it looks really, really, really cool. And I'm going to show you in better detail over on the white background, so you can see the car in its glory without my face all over the screen. But yeah, let's have a look at this and let's see what we think of it. Let's give it a good old review. So this is Nat's creation, what has been built out of the Fiat 500. And I think you'll agree, in the blue, it looks visibly striking. It looks so cool. I think personally, so much better than the yellow. But personal taste, your opinion might differ. That's fine, that's cool. If you agree with me, comment down below. If you don't agree with me, comment down below. Always good to see comments on what people think about sets. So let's hear it for Nat on this one. Let's see what you really think about this one. Now, the shape of it. For the state, let me just say as well, what Nat's done here is created a different car, a sports car, a racing sports car, out of a kit that is a Fiat 500, a 1960s Fiat 500. You know, it looks so good. It's such a good build. Now, you still get the nice little opening doors with this one. You still get the interior, which looks pretty good. I mean, obviously it's slicker and closer to the ground because it's, you know, more of a race car. Now, when you do close the doors, there is a little bit of resistance and that does tend to happen a little bit. But it's no big deal because at the end of the day, it is just for the look of the actual car. So, but yeah, they still managed to use the windscreen piece. There's all really, really good method of building in there to make that, you know, the shape of the rake on the windscreen and everything, which looks really, really cool. Now, like I say, to say he's used just the pieces out of the Fiat 500 is just phenomenal in itself. You know, and yeah, the shape is just there. It just looks so good. Yeah, around the other side, obviously it's a car, much of the same. And the front there, so you've got like this nice little angle on the nose there. Now that is achieved by clipping a piece in, so obviously that can actually move like that. It's, you know, just for the visible thing, it has to stay in that position. You know, it's driving along, it wouldn't be started doing this all the way down the road, which is silly.
But yeah, subsequently with that small piece there, it is only held on by two studs at the bottom, so it does come off quite easily. Now that is the only downfall to it, but if you just press on the bottom there and press together there, it secures it back again and you're okay to go. But yeah, so that part is a little bit delicate, so just be careful with the front end. So, but yeah, visibly it works, it looks good, and yeah, just a little bit delicate with the front end because there is only a few pieces holding it together, so it will. It was a little bit on the fiddly side to build as well, that front end. Other than that, really, really cool. Now we come round to the back end. Like I say, we've got all the shape at the back. He's even got the light pieces in place, and you know, it just looks really good. You've got twin turbo exhaust, twin turbo diesel petrol fusion injection. I don't know. Anyway. But yeah, so it just looks really, really cool. I love the shape he's managed to get in the back end here. You know, it just oozes awesomeness all the way around. And one amazing function on this one is... You have to do sound effects as well. It's a legal requirement. And in there, you've got a small... Well... a little V8 engine in the back, you know, and it just nicely just opens up. Just really well, really well thought out. And yeah, it just works. It just looks so good. Now, I hope you'll agree, I've just knocked an exhaust off, but never mind. I hope you'll agree that this looks amazing. You should go to Rebrickable now, buy these instructions, they're not expensive. You should look at Nat's other builds out there, and you should get some for yourself, because there is nothing wrong with extending the build life of your Lego sets. So what better way to have a relatively cheap creator set and have lots more builds out of it and lots more fun. Get over there. Link in the description below. Go and buy the instructions. Tell them Brick McBricksworth sent you, obviously. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this small little video on this review of how cool this is. Okay, it was very one-sided. It's very cool. I really enjoyed building it. Marks out of 10 for this thing. I give it... just for the front end, I'm going to have to mark it down a tiny bit, but that's no fault. Again, honestly, it's no fault of Nat's for the build, because to build something like this out of just the pieces from a Fiat 500, for effort, it's a definite 11 out of 10. It's over 10 out of 10. But just on that front end, I'd say we give it about an 8.5 of overall building. But, yeah. It's visibly brilliant. The build was fun. The instructions are not expensive. And it just brought several hours more building fun doing it like that, having a different build. And I can't personally wait to build the other builds from Nat Bricks. Guys, it's been a pleasure. And tell us what you think. Head over to Rebrickable. Buy Nat's instructions and remember to head over to McBricksBricks.com, where you will find Lego deals and other things such as light kits from Game of Bricks and display stands and things like that, and where to get them and where to get the best deals on these things. See you later. Bye bye.